I want to talk to you about a package called Swift Algorithms. It's an official package published by the Swift team that contains useful methods for when you're working with sequences and collections. And while this package does contain some very specific methods that most iOS developers will probably never need to use, it also contains some very useful helper functions that solve problems many iOS developers will be facing. So I made a top 5 of the functions in this package that all iOS developers should be aware of. Let's start with number 1. If you ever need to implement pagination in your app, the method chunked will be very useful. You can use it to split a collection into chunks of a fixed size or based on a predicate. Alternatively, you can also indicate how many chunks you want and let it split the elements appropriately. Next, for number 2, we have random sample. This function allows you to take a random sample of a sequence or a collection. If you've ever had to implement random sampling yourself, you know how easy it is to mistakenly introduce bias in the selection. So being able to rely on an official implementation is quite welcome. Now for number 3, we have the function indexed. Indexed works in a very similar way to the function enumerated, except that whereas enumerated returns an increasing count, indexed will return the actual indices of the elements, which means that you can in turn safely use these indices to subscript the original collection without the risk of causing a crash at runtime. For number 4, we have the functions minCount and maxCount. These functions are very useful if you ever need to retrieve only the n smallest or largest elements from a large sequence, because they don't need to fully sort the original sequence to return their result, which makes them run faster. And finally, for number 5, we have 3 functions: compacted, first non-nil, and unict. I chose these 3 functions because they all solve a very basic and common problem, and so there's a good chance that you've already implemented one of them yourself. But if you prefer, you can choose to use the implementation of the Swift Algorithms package instead, which has the advantage of being thoroughly tested and optimized. And that's it, we've reached the end of this top 5. I've only showed you a glimpse of what the Swift Algorithms package contains, so I would really recommend that you take 2 minutes to read its full list of features. Maybe you'll find something that can help you save a lot of time and energy. That's all for this video, I hope that you've enjoyed it. If you're already using the Swift Algorithms package, please share your feedback with me in the comments. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss my next videos. Thank you for watching, and see you next time!